Minister of Music here, and I'm delighted that y'all have joined us for this program of sacred music of the German Baroque. Our special guests this afternoon are Deux, Crystal Gerald Johnson and Angela Malik, accompanied by string trio and organ. Our artist biographies are on the back page of your program for you to peruse. Also note that our violinists are playing Baroque violins, so their sound is softer with a straighter tone than modern violins. They're made with gut strings, and you may want to ask them about their instruments after the performance. We want to thank the Texas Commission on the Arts, as well as our church's Fine Arts Fund for underwriting this performance. We are live streaming this performance right now, and it will be posted to our church's YouTube channel after the concert for those who have not been able to attend. Deux will be back with us on Thursday, December 16th for our third Noel's at Noon program. So if you have friends or family that would like to hear them, you can invite them back. They will be performing selections from their Christmas album, Hodie Christus Natus Est, which I recorded with them 2 years ago. And the album was picked up by Centaur Records, and there will be a limited release of copies for sale at that Noel's at Noon program. This is a perfect time and place for today's concert. We just celebrated the 504th anniversary of the Lutheran Reformation here, and this music that you'll hear today would have been performed in Lutheran worship services in Germany 300 or 400 years ago. Please plan to follow the translations closely in your program if you are not a German speaker. Not only is this concert one of spiritual refreshment, but it is also a very interesting slice of music history. You'll get to hear the music of Schütz, one of the last composers in the Renaissance to compose in the old style, meaning there's a primary emphasis on vocal lines and the harmonies are modal. With Buxtehude and the Middle Baroque period, we have a move towards more functional harmony and instruments playing a larger role in the composition. Then finally, with Bach, we hear the mastery of form, harmony, and counterpoint in the highly ornate style of the Baroque. There will be a short intermission of 5 to 10 minutes after the first half, but right now, please join me in welcoming Deux. I'd like to say a few words about the two Buxtehude pieces that you'll hear next. They're both chaconnes, but one is for organ solo and the other one is for voices and instruments. A chaconne can also be called a passacaglia, and it's a common compositional device in the Baroque. It's a foundational bass line and or chord pattern that's repeated throughout the entire composition. The first chaconne you'll hear is based on a 4-measure pattern and the second on an 8-measure pattern. These two are both in minor keys, and the varied repetitions that are continually decorated give these pieces a haunting and ethereal feel. And interestingly, it is said that the organ chaconne that you'll hear by Buxtehude is the model for Bach's famous Passacaglia in fugue in C minor.
Thank you.
Please join me in re-welcoming Deux.
Thank you. Oh.